There is a big debate to define what sustainable development is. This landmark, from the report Our Common Future of the well-known Brundtland Commission, first appeared in 1987. Sustainable development is the development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. But what does this mean? What are the needs of the present? The mentioned definition contains within it two key concepts that are essential to characterize the sustainable development. The concept of needs, in particular the essential needs of the world's poor, to which priorities should be given, and the idea of limitations imposed by the state of technology and the social organization on the environment's ability to meet present and future needs. The satisfaction of human needs and aspiration is the major objective of development. The essential needs of people in developing countries for food, clothing, shelter, jobs are not being met. And beyond their basic needs, the people have legitimate aspirations for an improved quality of life. The GINI index represents the disparity of income among the population of the same country, between the richest and the poorest. It has increased almost everywhere in the world. Despite this difference among rich and poor people, the wellness of countries has increased from the last century. This is visible by analyzing the growth of the Human Development Index, an index developed by United Nations, which merges life expectancy, global domestic product per capita, and literacy rate for each country. The Brundtland Commission of 1987 stated also that a world in which poverty and inequity are endemic will always be prone to ecological and other crises. Therefore, sustainable development requires meeting the basic needs of all and extending to all the opportunity to satisfy their aspirations for a better life. However, the most threatened and most severely impacted by water, energy, and food insecurity are invariably the world's poor. Indeed, a rising global population and growing prosperity are putting unsustainable pressures on resources. Demand for water, food, and energy is expected to rise in the next two decades, while economic disparities incentivize short-term responses in production and consumption that undermine long-term sustainability. FAO says that agriculture accounts for 70% of total global freshwater withdrawals, making it the largest user of water. Water is used for agriculture production, forestry, and fishery along the entire agri-food supply chain, and it is used to produce or transport energy in different forms. At the same time, the food production and supply chain consumes about 30% of total energy consumed globally. Energy is required to produce, transport, and distribute food, as well as to extract, pump, lift, collect, transport, and treat water. Finally, cities, industries, and other users too claim increasingly more water, energy, and land resources, and at the same time face problems of environmental degradation and, in some cases, resource scarcity. Achieving at the same time full growth potential and sustainable development, therefore, clearly requires economic growth in places where such needs are not being met. Elsewhere, it can be consistent with economic growth, provided the content of growth reflects the broad principles of sustainability and non-exploitation of others. But growth by itself, it's not enough. High levels of productive activity and widespread poverty can coexist and can endanger the environment. Sustainable development requires that societies meet human needs both by increasing productive potential and by ensuring equitable opportunities for all. But how do we decide whose needs are met? Poor or rich people? Citizens or immigrants? These generations or the next generations? When there has to be a trade-off, whose needs should go first?